So let's continue our discussion of the fundamental vector subspaces of a matrix. We already talked about the null space of a matrix. So those were all the vectors x such that ax equals 0. In this video, I want to talk about the column space of a matrix. That's the vector space that's spanned by the columns of the matrix. Why is the column space important? If we look at a simple case of a 2x2 matrix, A, B, C, D, and multiply that matrix by some arbitrary column vector, so we'll multiply that by x1 and x2, we know what this is from our definition of matrix multiplication. This is just AX1 plus BX2 in the first row, and CX1 plus DX2 in the second row. But we can write this in another way that's rather revealing. We can split this up into two terms. The first one has X1 multiplied by the column vector AC. And the second term has x2 multiplied by the column vector BD. Okay? The column vector AC is just the first column of the matrix. The column vector BD is just the second column of this matrix. So multiplication of a matrix by a column vector is just a linear combination of the columns of the matrix. This right-hand side is in the column space of the matrix. So when we write AX equals B and assume that that has a solution, B has to be in the column space of the matrix A, right? AX has to be in the column space of the matrix A. So that's why the column space of a matrix is important. So the question here is, we want to find a basis for the column space. I'm going to call the column space COL of A, right? Find a basis for the column space of A and its dimension. Okay, the dimension of the column space. So not all columns of a matrix may be linearly independent. So the basis may end up being a smaller number of columns than what the matrix has, right? So the basis, all the vectors in a basis are supposed to be linearly independent. Okay, so I think the easiest way to understand how to find a basis for the column space of a matrix is to work an example. So I've already written an example on the board. Here we have a matrix A, which is 3 rows by 5 columns, 3 by 5. Column space of A is the space spanned by these 5 columns, but because there's only 3 rows, there are too many columns, so some of these columns have to be linearly dependent. So to determine a basis then for the column space of A, the procedure is to figure out the reduced row echelon form of A, RREF of A. Remember, you do that by finding a pivot and then eliminating all the elements below the pivot. And here, when you do that on this matrix A, you find that you have 2 pivot columns, this one and this one. These are called pivot columns. And then you end up with a row of zeros at the end. So this row reduction procedure, where you multiply a row by a constant and add it to a row below it, doesn't affect the linear dependence relationships between the columns. Okay, what does that mean? If you look at this second column here, you can actually see that it's minus 2 times the first column, right? So 6 is minus 2 times minus 3. Minus 2 is minus 2 times 1. Minus 4 is minus 2 times 2, right? If you look at the two columns in the reduced row echelon form of A, the second column is still minus 2 times the first column. So this process of row reduction doesn't affect these relationships, right? So if you look at the columns of the, in this row-reduced echelon form, you'll see that the second column is linearly dependent because it's just minus 2 times the first column. The fourth column is linearly dependent because it's minus 1 times the first column plus 2 times the third column, okay? In fact, all of the columns of this matrix will be linearly dependent on the pivot columns. Only the pivot columns are linearly independent. So that means the first and the third column are linearly independent. But the column space is not spanned by 1, 0, 0, and 0, 1, 0. The column space is spanned by the corresponding column vectors in the original matrix, so these two columns. So the procedure here is to find the reduced row echelon form of A, determine the pivot columns, and then those columns in the original matrix then form a basis for the column space. So we have the column space of A, then, is going to be the span of these two basis vectors, minus 3, 1, 2, and minus 1, 2, 5. Okay, and in this particular case, or in general, I guess, the dimension of the column space of A is going to be equal to the number of pivot columns and here it's only 2, right? 2. Okay. So this is what the column space is. Let me review. So the column space is the space that's spanned by the matrix times a column vector, okay? In that sense, it's a very fundamental vector space of this matrix. And if you want to find a basis for the column space of A, that means you want to find the columns of the matrix that form a linearly independent set. You do that by finding the reduced row echelon form of A, determine the pivot columns, and it is the pivot columns of the original matrix that form a basis for the column space. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.